Anne Horan.
And then we'll see our Toy Group winners for Crufts 2010. The smallest of the dogs at the show, the little companion dogs, you could probably fit the entire group on a decent-sized sofa.
The first of our Toy Group breeds, led by the Atom Pincher.
Lights up, and here they come into the ring. Led off by the little Atom Pincher. 89 of them judged this year, and this is our best of breed winner.
And here's the Australian Silky going in now, full of running.
Often the atmosphere gets them, doesn't it, on their run-in, they get rather excited. The little Bichon Frise.
Looking in great form.
The Bolognese.
From Italy, the Bolognese. We could say it's a saucy little breed.
The Cavalier King Charles Spaniel.
And here we have the Cavalier King Charles coming in after the Bolognese. One of the most popular breeds at home with you on the sofa. I'm sure there are many watching this evening.
And here's the long coat Chihuahua, full of running, very cheeky. Having a good look around the surroundings. Now we should be followed very soon by
a pair of feet.
And the smooth coat Chihuahua, wonderful top line on that one coming in. Very smart. And there is the Chinese crested coming in.
I remember my daughter, the first time she ever saw one of these, saying, oh, look, mummy, it's My Little Pony. Fantastic characters. The Coton de Tulier coming in after the Chinese crested.
And there's the distinctive outline of the English Toy Terrier. So, sharply pricked ears.
And here we have, coming in after the English Toy Terrier, the Griffon Bruxellois. Little monkey face coming towards you.
The red rough one coming in there.
Very cheeky looking.
And there's the Havanese, the dog of Malta. Or Cuba, I should say, sorry.
The fine bones of the Italian greyhound. Very graceful little toy dog.
And there's the Japanese chin. Distinctive actions, a bit of lift to its front legs on the move.
The King Charles Spaniel. There's the Japanese chin again. There's the King Charles Spaniel.
And a tricolour. Very smart. And here's the Lurchin, the little lion dog.
The Maltese.
The smooth flowing coat and lovely black pigment of the Maltese. Always a popular dog in the toy group.
And that's followed in by the smart, clean-cut outline of the Miniature Pincher. It's slightly high lifting action in front.
Enjoying itself. The little butterfly dog, the Papillon.
Now, this is interesting, Jessica. This is from America, and it's a Phelene. It's a drop-eared, which is the rarer form.
And the Pekingese. There'll be Peter salivating in the corner, fanning himself with delight at the sight of the Pekingese.
And this one's come from Holland.
The Pomeranian.
The little Pomeranian.
Brisk action and foxy face coming in, full of confidence.
Followed by the Pug.
And there's the Pug.
Now, this looks very smart and full of its own importance, which is typical of the breed.
And the last of our little toy dogs, the Yorkshire Terrier.
And I think our best of breed winner here has come all the way from Spain.
So that's the last of our toy dogs crossing the ring in front of Judge Anne Horan, and she will now take a look at her lineup. Always hot competition in the toy group, isn't there, Frank?
Yes. Anne Horan here has been a breeder of Cavaliers with her husband and her daughter, Victoria. She's also had some curly-coated retrievers and some other breeds. Now we're getting that low camera angle. The very smart outline of the Bichon in great form. The little Bolognese with its curly flocks.
That looks like a lovely Cavalier.
Beautiful. Nice to see a tricolour making the group. The smart top line of the Chihuahuas.
Taking a look at the camera, who are you? The Chinese crested.
There's the Coton de Tulia, and having a little bark, the English Toy Terrier, and the Griffon.
Havanese, steady as a rock.
And a very elegant, beautiful shape on the Italian Greyhound, and that's a very nice cobby shape for the Japanese chin. And there's the Lurchen, the spectacular Maltese in great form.
That's a delightful picture, isn't it? Wagging tail, and as you say, the drop-eared Papillon. That's unusual. I'm not sure I've ever seen one of those
and
in a group
huge
here at Crufts.
Huge entry today. It's a top 267. So,
and the Yorkshire Terrier.
128 of those here today.
Now, the first on the table. This is the Affenpinscher. This one champions Scarpafield Schwartz Legacy. Just 21 months old, this dog, Jericho. He's owned by Barry Wiggins and was bred by Jenny Wiggins, who's handling in the ring tonight. Now, 5 challenge certificates so far and winning Crufts at Crufts today.
At 21 months, which is some going, and it topped a brilliant entry today for breed specialist Tony Teasdale, who was judging them. Now, this is a fantastic breed. They've got great characters. Originally, the little black devil dogs of Germany. So they've got this impish face with them, those small, dark eyes. And they're very sturdy dogs. They're square. They should have this typical tail carriage, slightly curved over the back. They should look natural. They're an untrimmed breed in this country. They're a bit more stylized in America and in some other places. And they have a fairly brisk action because they're angulation. They don't have a lot of angulation at either end, so they're relatively moderate strides on the breed.
It's a very sweet little monkey face.
They should have a
it?
Sort of elevated goose step action, which comes from that angulation. We see that brisk, choppy, goose stepping action.
The Australian Silky Terrier, this one, curiosity to talk about Kayako, who's imported from Finland. Owned by Kevin Sharp Dixon and Jude Reyes, bred by Christina Heinonen and Sares, it says here. A handler in the ring is Kevin Sharp Dixon tonight. They come from Penwith in Cumbria.
And we see a very alert expression. We can see a little bit of the Australian Terrier in it, and we see the colours of the Yorkshire Terrier, and that's exactly where the breed derived from. So it's got elements of both. That terrier quality in the head and ears and outlook, and the wonderful colours and coat texture of the Yorkshire. Now, bred in Finland, Finland has a lot of good breeders and a lot of breeds, and particularly in this breed. We saw also a smooth collie bred in Finland winning the other day, and here we have another lovely quality dog.
Very smart looking on the move.
Lovely level top line, very good colours. The colours, the blue and tan, very important.
Is it as important as it is with the Yorkshire Terrier? Because I know it's a huge part of their breed standard.
Absolutely. So they combine toy and terrier. And so, but you're quite right, the coat, texture and colour, very important in judging the breed.
Now the Bichon Frise with a very capable handler here. We always know we need to look out for something good, don't we? This one is champion Pamplona Bring Me Sunshine, 2-year-old dog. He's known as Eric at home. He was bred by Michael Code, who owns him. And of course, he's handled by Jeff Corrish in the ring tonight.
Yes, this dog is in peak condition. I think he's called Eric, isn't he?
Which is, he is.
Not a very French or Bichon name, is it? But look at that wonder. You can see from here the texture of that coat. Loose corkscrew curls to it, which should be soft to the touch. See the handler, the judge there picking up the pads.
Checking the pad.
They have to be black pigmentation. We see the black on its nose, and we'll turn around, there's lovely dark eyes which set off in that face. Beautiful expression. Now, this dog for me looked marvellous, and he's going really well. I think he'll have a strong chance later.
Because it's not just about all the dogs who've got through to best of breed and they come through to the group are going to be brilliant specimens of their breed. To win the group, you also need that extra notch, don't you? You need the performance, you need the showman, and that is a little show dog.
Performance and presence on the night, and this dog has it in buckets, yeah? Now, great for the Bichon Frise, means it's a white curly dog, curly coat, so.
And here we have another white curly coat.
Fantastic.
This is the Bolognese.
I do like the Bolognese. Just look at those loose flocks. It's absolutely typical. It's sort of ungroomed, but it falls in loose flocks. Anyway, who is it, Jessica?
This one is Chanel Canny Bohemia. Chanel at home with Caroline Jonegans. I hope I pronounced that correctly. Bred by Eva Gerikova, and they come from Holland.
Yeah, beautiful. I do like this breed. They should be square and sturdy. There's a lovely, sturdy, chunky quality to the breed. And again, like a lot of these Mediterranean breeds, the pigmentation and the coat very important. We see very nice black pigmentation on its nose, its lips, and round its eyes. They're an enchanting breed. Look at that lovely straight movement coming towards us.
And they're great characters. A lot of people mistake toy dogs as just being little, small, insignificant people, and they absolutely are not.
Look at those lovely dark eyes coming out of that white coat. That's fabulous. I do like that. Wonderful specimen of the breed. Square and sturdy. Just look at the shape and outline and balance on that. Full of confidence. Who says they're fragile little things, these toy breeds?
Now on to what must be just about the most, one of the most popular breeds. This is the Cavalier King Charles Spaniel. There were 156 dogs and 198 bitches shown at Crufts today. This one came through though, champion Loranca's Sherry Bay. Sherry's 2 years old, and in fact they were judged by Ellis Hume, but Anne Horan had to referee the decision between the dog and the bitch and chose this dog.
Yes, I'd better explain that there were two judges, 156 Cavalier dogs here today and 198 Cavalier bitches. Two judges, best dog sent forward, best bitch sent forward, and the two judges couldn't agree. So in cases like that, the group judges brought in and she chose this very nice tricolour bitch.
Bred and owned by Lorraine Hughes, who's handling in the ring tonight and winning their fourth CC today. What do you think?
Fabulous. It's nice to see a tricolour winning. We often see the Blenheims, the chestnut and whites winning. Beautiful top line, cobby and compact, which is just as the breed should be. Beautiful flat coat in great form. That look, I like that very much.
Now another very popular breed numerically. This is the long-coated Chihuahua. This one, champion Diella Buccaneer, nearly 2 years old, is Flynn. He's owned by Diane Lunny, or Looney, I'm not sure how to pronounce it. I think Lunny probably. Six CC so far and not yet 2 years old. So that's quite impressive, isn't it?
Yes, it's a very good career for a dog who's not yet two. So there we see the lovely domed skull of the breed and the large flaring ears set at about 45 degrees to the skull, and these large eyes and beautiful cheeky expression.
Flynn
there.
Looks like he's having a wee snooze there.
What are you doing to me, he says. Yes. So now, reputedly the smallest breed in the world, but try and tell them that, because they're full of their own importance, full of mischief. There you are, full of confidence, out his stride, and the tail should be carried in a little arch over the back, not tight to the back, should have a little lift to it. This is the long-coated, which means they've got this feathering on the ears, down the ruff of the neck, and some furnishings underneath the body.
And a breed that we see great quality in this country, don't we? We've consistently seen super long coats in the group here at Crufts.
Believe me, for dogs so tiny, they have such a sense of self-importance.
There's the little long-coated Chihuahua. And now we're going to move on to his smooth-coated cousin. This one, Dachida's Colour Me Blue, Mfanwi. She's just 1.5 years old, so again, 18 months and winning best of breed at Crufts. She already has two CCs. Bred by Carol Davis, who also owns her, but handled by Amy in the ring. They come from Stockport in Manchester.
And very interesting colours on this, and it's a sort of party colour. It looks like a sort of bluish body with tan markings, so very stylish and striking. But you know, apart from the coat, it shares the same breed standard as the long coat. But this is the smooth coat, which has a bit of density to it.
Both varieties can be found in many different colours.
But again, you see more the shape of the head and the ears because there's no furnishings on them. There was a domed skull, a very smart in its carriage. Look at that beautiful level top line. Perfect tail carriage on this one. Very smart striding out. You know, just because they're small, Jessica, they still have to be sturdy and they have to be good movers. They have to be well assembled.
That dog looks so smart. Very nice little smooth coat
and
Chihuahua.
Beautiful clean neck and shoulders. Very nice length of neck. Gives it a degree of elegance. Look at that. Degree of elegance in that one, yes.
It's nice to see them enjoying themselves too, isn't it? This is the Chinese Crested. Prefix the name of the game. Rigmor, he belongs to Annika and Anna Carlson. They come from Sweden and was bred by Gunilla and Rebecca Agronius, a very famous Swedish kennel prefix.
Absolutely, and again, now this looked very stylish coming in. This is a unique breed. Now, here we see this is the hairless type, and the judge feeling the skin, they're fairly hot to the touch, but they have this wonderful furnishings down the ears, down the crest of the neck, and over their wrists and over their feet. So that's the correct coat pattern. They also come in the long-coated variety, which we know as the powder puffs, but we can have them in the same litter. So, and they're shown in the ring also. Now this one just seemed a little bit unsettled on the table. So
looks
let's see if she gets her act together.
Look at
absolutely.
That tail.
as you say, your daughter called it My Little Pony, which is just right. It's a very nice level top line, the tail carried nicely, and that plume of hair running down like a mane.
Lovely ring presence too, enjoying itself and really showing. Not too sure about the judge though, little tail gone down again. Now we move on to the table again with the Cotton de Tulière. This one is Cottonbury Anastasia. She's a world champion, a French champion, international and Italian champion at 4 years old. Her name's Stacy. She belongs to Ellie De Luca, and she was bred by Ellie and Franco De Luca, and of course they've come from Italy. 15 challenge certificates so far, 4 groups.
And we see it's a breed of Mediterranean origins, and again the coat texture, Coton de Tulière. They have texture of the coat like the old-fashioned cotton. It's a fairly hard to the touch. And they've got a unique top line, a rise over the loin and a drop to the tail. And the tail is carried relatively low. So and again, the pigmentation, very important on the breed. So let's see if this one goes well.
And it's interesting, isn't it, to see the same theme, this beautiful coat, the black pigment, appearing in several breeds in this group, but originating from different countries within the world. They're all companion dogs, they're all bred as companion dogs, and this theme obviously extremely popular in the origins of these breeds.
Of course, many of the toy breeds bred, as you say, to be house companions, to be pretty, elegant, attractive in the house. So, now,
the English Toy Terrier, champion Whitstone Telling Tales, and of course it was the Whitstone English Toy Terriers that made it to the final 8 in the breeders' competition that we saw yesterday. This 4-year-old bitch is called Lizzie. She was bred by Nick Gowley and Andrew Leonard, who of course are showing her tonight. This is Nick in the ring. They come from Ashbourne in Derbyshire. 14 cc's, this particular one.
Now, I said that many of the toy breeds were bred to be decorative. This was very purposeful because it used to work in the ratting pits, so it was good at keeping down the vermin. There, it is in. We saw the Manchester Terrier yesterday in the Terrier group. This is in many ways a scaled-down version. That beautiful black and tan coloration, the thumbprints on its tan markings on its front legs, a slight rise over the loin is desirable, and they should have an extended trotting action.
And so despite its origins, it ends up in the toy group because of its size and demeanor rather than the fact that it was...
It's a miniaturized version, yes. So it is one of the miniaturized breeds. So that's a very nice picture of its outline there.
Very characteristic body shape, isn't it?
And the ear shape too, which I've been speaking about today.
Now the little Griffon Bruxellois, this one, Romesi Royal Signature at Donzeta. Is it Donziata?
I call it Donziata.
Donziata. 20 months old she is. Her name's Gladys. They were judged by Michael Quinney today. Of course, she's owned by David Guy and was bred by Margaret Cook and Mandy Laidlaw. I think made up today.
Yeah. Yes, it won a big competition in September, last September. It was the top junior of the year, so for dogs up to 18 months old. Again, this is a sturdy cobby breed. This is the rough-coated variety, and it should stride out well. It should be well-ribbed. It's got a large head, dark eyes.
And that again, fantastic red coloration.
This was traditionally a dock breed. Now, docking is now not legal anymore, so they're now undocked, and we see the long tail. The only dogs that can be docked now, Jessica, are gun dogs, which are bred specifically for working, and we might see some of those tomorrow. But this is, it's still a young one, still not fully mature, but full of quality and full of breed type. And as you say, that beautiful, rich red coat texture. You can see the texture from here.
Nicely matching jacket on the handler, too. Now, the Havanese. This one is an American champion and a Dutch champion, Mr. Jumping Jack Flash Sweet Honesty. Before next month, his name's Jack. He belongs to Mieter van Hoot, who also bred him, and they've come here from the Netherlands. Best of breed at Crufts last year as well, so that's 2 years running.
Fantastic, and this is a breed which is really catching on. Now, we saw Lars Rapso in the utility group. Some people mistake this for that. They have some similarities, but a lot of dissimilarities. They have a breed-specific type. They come in this wonderful range of colours, and they have a very jaunty action and very distinctive top line. These are breed features. Very nice view of its head and its head proportions there. Very pleasing. So, and you see the handlers, the judge has gone well under the coat to feel the body proportions, the leg length, very important.
And it's terribly important, isn't it, in these very heavy coated breeds, and the Havanese has a huge coat on it, in order to be able to feel the construction. You can see it when it's moving, because that's moving soundly, but if you don't get your hands on it, you really can't feel what's underneath
the coat. Yes, it's a very nice jaunty, springy action, striding well there. Again, we had quite a lot of them here today. We had 68 of them, which is the breed is growing.
They've developed, haven't they,
yes.
And grown dramatically in the last few years. The graceful elegance of the Italian Greyhound. This one, Dallinset Pamina. She's just 19 months old. Her name's Lily. She belongs to Russell, David and Linda Hodges, who also bred her. They come from Oundle in Northamptonshire. And she was made up to a champion today, so I'm sure they'll be celebrating later.
What a picture of fine elegance she is, which is just what she should be. Miniaturised down from the Greyhound, and so that's where we get the shape from, the arched back, which the judge is now seeing. The muscular loin, which is what the bigger greyhounds had, but we keep it all. And there, the judge looking at down the limbs, they are fine bones. They should be fine bone, but strong in the bone. And they've got this wonderful, fine textured coat and skin, beautiful to the touch. Like pieces of Dresden china.
That's
so elegant.
I was just going to say, they have that quality about them,
yes.
Don't they? Like a little
China
ornament.
It looks like this bit of Ladro, doesn't it? It's very smart, yes, beautiful. Fine and elegant. And they have a very distinctive action in front, picking them up a little bit, which is correct for the breed. So, high stepping.
And despite the appearance of fragility, a little dog presenting a beautiful outline and not looking remotely
absolutely.
Faced by this big
and,
ring.
And holding that outline on the move, it doesn't lose its shape.
The distinctive black and white coloration of the Japanese chin. This one, champion Jainan Figaro Sleepy Hollow, Figgy, owned by Tony Alcock and bred by Miss Wainwright and Mrs. Hodgson.
Now, again, if the... viewers might recognise the handler because he's a famous champion for Crown Green Bowling. He was a world champion at one stage, I think, Tony. But this is his great passion, his dogs. And he's had great success with his Japanese chins, and this one of the best.
Well, this one winning his 22nd challenge certificate today, so quite a show record there.
Yes, and the chin has a cat-like face. He's got beautiful plush muzzle. The expression, having a little bit of white in the corner of its eye, gives it this distinctive expression. Again, this is a black and white. They'll also come in a lemon white or orange and lemon and white. Silky textured coat and the cobby body, very important. And they should have a little bit of lift to their front action. There, and there he goes.
Winning best of breed over 94 other Japanese chins today, so quite a substantial entry.
Dainty boned, but cobby in the body. Yes, fine boned, cobby body. Putting a nice show there.
A little bit of a treat to get that nice expression for the judge. Now, this is the King Charles Spaniel, as distinct from the Cavalier King Charles. This one, champion Amantra, cheers an affix that we know very well in the group ring here at Crufts. 4 years old is Nigel, owned by Tracy Jackson and Di Fry, who, of course, also bred in. They come from North Somerset.
Yes, you will see the beautiful dome skull there. They are one of the Royal Spaniels from the... Okay, so we go back to the 17th century to see the Cavalier and the King Charles we have here in the royal court.
Oh, I'm absolutely certain if you go to any stately home in England anywhere, you will see a painting somewhere in the house that includes one of these dogs.
Absolutely, and there we see the lovely domed skull, shorter in the muzzle than the Cavalier, and more domed in the skull, and beautiful large dark eyes. And however, they're a bit smaller than the Cavalier, but they should be very sound. And this one, wonderful temperament, wagging its tail there, striding out well, silky textured coat and wonderful furnishings on
it's
the
ears. It's
delightful
to see the character in that dog. You
and
really
you know, in the
can.
Old days, the owners used to put ribbons around their ears to adorn their ears to give them an extra attraction in the house.
Oh, I don't think it needs ribbons. I think
but
it's doing quite
two
well
centuries
on its
ago,
own.
They might have done that. Yes.
Now, you have to tell me the correct pronunciation. Is it the Lurvchen?
I usually say it that way, yes.
Right, that's what it is, the little lion dog to the rest of us. This one is an international and UK champion, Chico Noblesse Aura. 5 years old now he is. His name's Chico. He belongs to Patricia Neal and Jane Ekova and was bred by Mrs. Paula Pavlikova. They live in Lincolnshire. He has 3 cc's, so I think he was made up to a champion today.
Yeah, very good. Now, this is a breed which is quite distinctive in its trim because it's called a lion dog because it has this mane of hair at the front, like the lion, and this clipped rear, so its hindquarters are bare, and it has these little socks from its hocks down. So it gives it this lion-like appearance.
A bit like a Portuguese water dog.
And they should also have a fairly square, short head. And this one looks to have a very nice short, square skull, short foreface, and it should stride out well. There are another of the breeds which should be short and square in that outline. It's coming towards us very nicely there. And holding his top line well.
The little
that
lion dog.
Fine fall of coat in its mane.
That's a lovely outline there. What a picture, the Maltese. This one, champion Benetone Gold Ring, 4 3/4 years old, the 3/4 being very important, I'm sure. This is Miles. He belongs to Sarah and Rosemary Jackson, who also bred him, and it's Sarah Jackson who's handling in the ring tonight. They come from Northampton. This little dog has 33 challenge certificates and has won 23 groups at championship level. That is a huge achievement.
And he's won 4 best in shows, and that's shows almost of the size of Crufts, so he's a prolific winner. And I've seen him a lot of times, and I've judged him, but I don't think I've ever seen him looking as good as he looks today. And, you know, he sometimes is over-exuberant on the move. He was very collected when he came in and held that top line. Now, fabulous breed, beautiful white silky coat, dark pigmentation, very important. Now, to take him so fast, Sarah, just slow him down, and there he is.
So he could be a real contender tonight, a dog with form like that and in this condition looking so good.
That top line, perfect tonight. So, you know, good handlers, it's important that you take the dog at the right speed for them and it keeps their coordination and balance. Get them too fast and they lose that, lose the shape. He sometimes gets so keen on things, he runs away with it all.
Well, it's nice to see him putting in a good performance when it really matters in the group at Crufts. This is the miniature pincher, champion Hawks Flight Seal with a Kiss. He's Rory, he's 2.5 years old, he belongs to Donald and Heather Smith and was bred by Nicky Mackey. They've come from North Wales today and he's won his 4th cc, he also has 6 reserve cc's.
Now, here's something quite distinctive. We've just had the glamour of a Maltese, here we have the pincher. We've seen the Doberman pincher in the working group, it was 2nd in the working group. Okay, we've seen the other, the standard size pincher also there, and here's the miniaturized version. Pincher in German means terrier, and they were bred for ratting, and so they also have some sort of capabilities to work.
You can see the character there, he's eyeing up everybody else in the
absolutely
lineup.
Absolutely. And now, the thing about this is, like the other pinchers, he should be short and square, a hard sloping top line, this sharp featured head and expression, and they have a slightly different action, moving towards a little bit of hackney-ish in their front action, and that's important as a breed feature, and this high set tail well carried.
You see, dog looks like he's got enough character for about 4 of his friends as well. The little miniature pincher. Now we move to this very interesting Papillon. This one, champion Arcano's Fear to You, or is that Fars to You? His name's Cobb, he's 5 years old, and he belongs to Salwa Alfadal, Mary Jo Loy, and Kim Kay, and somebody whose name is Berg, and I can't read the first name because I think they got a bit excited towards the end of the sheet. Bred by Kim McKay, I think it's Murray Berg, actually, and they come from the United States, as you said.
And I think he's called Ears to You, which is very significant because we usually see the Papillon with flared butterfly ears. This is the Falen variety, where the ears lie fairly flat to the skull. They're drop ears. The Falen translates as the moth. This is the moth variety.
As opposed to the butterfly with the prick ears.
Absolutely, but see the wonderful furnishings on this dog in its dropped ears, and this silky luxuriant coat. This is a tricolour. Now, John Alton here, he's an Englishman, but he's been living in America. He's a professional handler in America, and he's flown over with this dog. He has been best in show at the Great Westminster Dog Show with a Papillon. Here, a great success with his Falen. He's had best of breed with a Papillon here before. Now he's achieved it with a Falen. It's a remarkable achievement.
And of course, in some of the agility competition here on our coverage, we've seen Papillons winning great things. It's not just about being a little toy dog sitting on someone's sofa at home. They're fantastic characters with a great deal of
and
stamina.
And long live. They go to 14 and 15 and are still fit and healthy.
In fact, I know someone who had one that was 19 years old and it was still wanted to go to agility classes. Now, the peak is missing. Unfortunately, it's left the ring, so we're going to move on to the Pomeranian. This is champion Lariva's Sir Finn the Net. And 3 years old, his name's Bunny. He belongs to Don Cothera and was bred by Avril Cothera Purdy. They come from Stroud in Gloucestershire. 12 CCs to his credit and 2 group placements as well.
Surf in the Net is called. It's a great character dog. Now we want to hear something of a foxy face. Foxy face and expression, and they should fit into a ball. They're so compact, they fit into a tight ball. So we'll see him go with his brisk action. There's an orange, which is a beautiful colour. Now that's an off-standing, harsh top coat. That high-set tail carried over the back and almost reaching the neck. So extremely compact, brisk in his action, like all of the Spitz breeds. He is the smallest of the Spitz breeds, and he's going very nicely
that
there.
Pom looks a complete picture, a huge roar from the crowd as it's set off. Is that for cuteness or is that for confirmation?
I've heard it said that this should look like a Jaffa orange on legs. So there you are. So
absolutely perfect. Nice performance there from the little Pomeranian.
And he holds back his head and he does fit into that little circle.
Now he's a lovely little wagging coil of a tail there on the pug that's on the table. This is champion Yolanda Ronaldo at Tidemill. Ronnie, he's only 2 years old. He belongs to Terry Purse and Nigel Marr from Southampton, was bred by Kathy Mindley. 17th challenge certificate today. So, and that's difficult to do in pugs. They're a very strong breed, aren't they?
Yes, a huge, huge competition. 277, as you say. 277 pugs here today, and here's the winner. Fantastic. I liked him when he came in. Beautiful dog.
That's a very sound, balanced looking front.
Look, strong, sturdy legs, broad chest, and he's got this wonderful pug face with lots of expression in it from that dark mask and big dark eyes. They're a lovely fine coated breed. The standard says multum in parvo, which means a lot of dog in a small compass. But look at that self-importance as he strides around there. That high set twist to his tail, another pug feature, and he's beautifully fine coated. This one, a fawn. So very nice performance.
He looks like he owns the place. Now we move to the last of our toy dogs in this group. This is the Yorkshire Terrier, a multi-champion, Estubos Leonardas, 3 years old. His name is Leo. They were judged by Mrs. Reader today. He's owned by Sergio Amien and Hugo Ibanez, who also bred him, and they come from Segovia in Spain, as you pointed out to start with, Frank.
Right, yes, and look at the colours on that. We want this shades of tan, the rich tan colouring and the head furnishings. Three shades of tan, deeper at the roots and fading to a paler gold at the end. Beautiful colours on this. And you see that the judge brushing the coat to see the texture and the correct colour demarcation. Steel blue is the correct colour for the body coat and three shades of tan. And she's going to see that the colour is all in the right places and the silky texture. They start darker and as they mature, they go to a steel blue. They don't have to be black and woolly. That's a big fault in the breed. Steel blue and tan markings. And of course, they are a toy with terrier instincts, and they, you know, should be full of character. Sharp, erect ears, nice top line on him.
And another breed that, of course, is incredibly popular as a pet at home, although very rarely kept in coat condition like this.
He's come from Spain, and the breed is very strong in Spain. A lot of successful breeders there. Now he's beaten 127 others to get here.
So that was the last of our toy dogs being looked at by our group judge this evening, Anne Horan, who's now going to go back down her line to assess the dogs, remind herself, of course, of the features that she's looked at when she's had her hands on them.
And we've just heard that the Pekingese handler was not well in the ring, and so he's had to retire. Very sad, because the Peek came in looking very nice and the handler's taken ill. Perhaps the excitement of winning at Crufts has done it for him.
840 toy dogs in the toy group, making 3,082 entries.
Now, walking down towards the middle of her line, the Italian Greyhound. There's the little Charlie.
Sunday night in the Best in Show ring, and I'm sure you're all wondering which one that's going to be.
Now she'll be thinking, which are my top eight here that I can have another look at.
We've got 14 dogs.
All the way down to the end of the line with the Yorkshire Terrier. And then she'll move back and start her selection.
I thought the Bichon went particularly well, Jessica, myself. The Maltese look good. There's some very nice dogs here.
Much food for thought.
Now, careful. Take the best eight. Take your time, Anne. In comes first of her dogs coming in a moment.
The Australian Silky.
And the Bichon comes out.
Moving down the line is the little Longcoat Chihuahua.
The English Toy Terrier comes in. And the Griffon.
Yes, she's taking the Maltese. And the little Pom.
Right, and there we are. She's got seven at the moment, I think.
Seven.
And that's it. She's got a short list of seven. Not the usual eight, perhaps, but that's what she wants to look at.
She looks like she's still thinking. No, that's it. She's decided.
She knows her own mind. So the others will now leave the ring.
So if the others would like to leave the ring, please, now. And let's have a round of applause.
That's it, away they go. So shaking hands with all the dogs who are now leaving the ring, the handlers of the dogs who are leaving the ring. And she'll keep her short list.
They'll be very happy to have got this far. They're getting best of breed at Crufts. And you know, another show, another judge. Another day, there you are.
They always say it's the dog on the day.
So here we are, seven then, from these 23 toy breeds. Our judge,
Anne Horan, has her final seven from the toy group. She's now going to take another look at them. What do you like the look of, Frank?
The Bichon gave a sparkling performance. He's in great form. So we'll see how he goes in this last... You know, at this stage, they should all be pretty close to perfection in their breeds. Performance and movement on the night might just clinch it.
So now she's gone back to the English Toy Terrier to start off with.
It's from the very famous Witchstone Kennel. It's Telling Tales, a big winner. This lovely extended trotting action, a distinct top line in the breed, and those candle flame shaped ears.
The next of her finalists is the Griffon Bruxellois, Gladys.
Yes, from
the Romacy Royal Signature at Donziata.
Yes, David Guy's had a lot of big winners. This still a junior, won top junior in the country last year and has taken her title, became a champion today. Look at that lovely rich red coat, compact cobby body, this high set tail, striding out well.
The Australian Silky Terrier.
This one, curiosity to talk about. Kiako, come all the way from Finland.
And I'm not surprised to see this making the shortlist. It's a beautiful specimen. Colours, very important. This has them. Beautiful coat texture, lovely top line, striking movement. I like it.
Champion Pamplona, bring me sunshine. Eric, the Bichon Frise, handled by Jeff Corrish, owned by Michael Code.
right, Bring Me Sunshine. He's put up a marvellous performance. Beautiful specimen of the breed. His coat, lovely, soft, loose corkscrew curls. Beautiful head and pigmentation. Looks a good dog for me tonight.
The character of the little long-coated Chihuahua, champion Diella Buccaneer. Flynn, 2 years old, belongs to Diane Lunny.
Very nice specimen. Lovely dome skull, flared ears, perfect top line, high set and carried tail, and striding out full of his own self-importance. The cheeky Chihuahua.
Now this glorious Maltese with such a fantastic show record, champion Benetton Gold Ring, Miles, with Sarah Jackson handling in the ring tonight.
Again, a perfect top line, lovely silky texture. Look at the black pigmentation on its lips and its eyes. Very nice.
And the Pomeranian, 1, 3, 5, 7.
And then we have this little Pomeranian, champion Larivas, Surf in the Net, Bunny, belonging to Handaway Avril Corthera, Purdy, owned by Don.
You see the lovely, harsh, off-standing coat, the high set. Look, a little Jaffa on legs, as I said before. Yes, compact, fitting into that little compact ball.
You have such a way with words, Frank. What will we do without you? Now the boards are out. Anne Horan will walk down the line, take another look, and she's got to pull out her group winner for tonight. Of course, the penultimate group, this toy group, we've only got the gun dogs to go tomorrow. Who is our sixth winner going to be? Looking again at the Griffon Bruxellois, the Australian Silky. Oh, she's starting to move with purpose.
And the winner is the Maltese.
It's the Maltese champion, Benetton Gold Ring. Look at Sarah's face. Absolutely delightful. Takes the toy group for Crufts 2010. Who's going into the group two spot?
Is it another white dog?
No, moving down to the end of the line there.
The English Toy Terrier,
the Witchstone Telling Tales, takes the second spot in the toy group. Very smart, gleaming condition.
Group three
goes to the little Griffon Bruxellois.
The junior bitch of David Guy from Seaham, County Durham. He's had lots of champions and he rates this one very highly.
Going straight across to congratulate Sarah. And here we are, group four goes to the Bichon Frise. And Jeff Corrish at the helm.
Little Eric, yes, and he put on a sparkling performance. Bring Me Sunshine, and he did.
And how delightfully sporting. Everybody goes across to congratulate the group winner before they go to take their place. And there she is, Sarah Jackson, with the Maltese champion Benetton Gold Ring.
I said, Jessica, when he came in, it was the best performance I'd seen him give. He was more composed and settled, and he's looking really good as he's ever looked, I think.
But how lovely is that? That, I mean, a toy dog, they tend to be long-lived, maturing slowly, to have had a career that he's had and then to go on and win the group at Crufts like this, that's absolutely fantastic.
And Sarah, a young breeder dedicated to her breed, you know, it takes a lot of dedication to keep dogs looking like this in this great condition.
There's the English Toy Terrier receiving group two.
For Andrew and Nick, they'll be very happy with that high group placement, and Anne Horan. And Betty Flavel giving the trophy here. She's a great breeder of Pomeranians and a great character and a very good judge of toys.
And finally in group four, the Bichon Frise.
There's Jeff, very happy with his success for his young dog. I say I liked him very much tonight. So there's a very nice group witness to join the others, Jessica.
Exactly, and off they go on their lap of honour. And of course, the next time this little Maltese steps into this ring, it will be for Crufts Best in Show tomorrow night. We have our sixth group winner, the Maltese.